Welcome to Wembley Stadium for a unique football occasion, the first final of the Freight Rover Trophy, the tournament that gives the third and fourth division clubs the chance to have their day at Wembley. And Brentford and Wigan Athletic can now savour that experience. Almost all the players have never played here before, but not the two managers. Frank McClintock, on the right of Brentford, took part in six finals here for Leicester City and for Arsenal. And Wigan's Brian Hamilton, four times a player here, three times in the green of Northern Ireland and once in the blue of Everton. And a tremendous Wembley roar greeting the arrival of the teams, both of whom have had the opportunity to train here this week, which doesn't happen, I can tell you, for the FA Cup final or the what has been the Milk Cup final. And for most of those players, it was their first feel of the famous Wembley turf. Team and their supporters, some of whom have walked to the stadium. It's about 5 miles as the crow flies, possibly 7 miles if you come by road, and a tremendous bank occupying the end where the Manchester United fans were for the FA Cup final here. Guest of honour barely needs identification, a man whose name is synonymous with entertainment, Elton John, on a day where entertainment is very much the key word here. It's being billed as the family final, and goodness knows football needs a boost to the image of the game, particularly this week. So Colin Methven, the Wigan captain, introducing his players to Elton John, who of course knows life in the third and fourth divisions only too well. As chairman of Watford Football Club, he and Graham Taylor lifted Watford here to Wembley in last year's FA Cup final. Martin Lange, a moment where he's so proud, the Brentford chairman, as Elton John is introduced by the Brentford captain, Terry Hurlock, to the Brentford players. Be a bit of wisecracking going on there. There'll be one or two wanting an autograph. Elton John's heart is very much in football. He's a genuine sportsman who has strong beliefs in the way the game should be played. Frank McClintock. And then the referee, Tom Bune, on the right there, with his two linesmen and the reserve official, a well-known Football League referee in his own right, Brian Hill. So for Robbie Cook and his Brentford teammates, what lies in store here at Wembley? They can hardly believe that their season has ended this way. But that's the appeal of the Freight Rover Trophy, as we now await the national anthem. let's get a check on the two teams, starting with Brentford, who are at full strength. Gary Phillips, the goalkeeper. A back four of Danny Salmon, Steve Wignall, Keith Millen, who is only 18, and Jamie Murray. Four in midfield. Keith Castles, who moved to Brentford from First Division football with Southampton. Terry Hurlock, the captain. Chris Kamara and Gary Roberts. Wigan have the vastly experienced Roy Tunks in goal. Their back four is Alex Cribley, Colin Methven, their captain, Steve Walsh and Barry Knowles, who was called in only this week when John Butler failed a fitness test. Gary Bennett at 22 is the oldest of a four-man midfield, which also includes 20-year-old Tony Kelly, Kevin Langley, who's just 21, and 19-year-old David Lowe. And their two strikers are Graham Barrow and Mike Newell. It is, as I say, a family day, and in the stand there, an area designated for an organisation called Soccer as Family Entertainment, SAFE, SAFE, the initials, and for the youngsters there, there are goodies offered to them by sponsors, flags and magazines, and one hopes from small beginnings it may play a major part in our football world. Brentford arrived in this final by beating third division opposition Reading, Cambridge United, Swansea City, and then a tremendous win at Bournemouth before they thrashed Newport County in that southern area final. And Wigan, for their part, fourth division opponents Wrexham, Bury, Tranmere Rovers, Brian Hamilton's old club, Lincoln City of the third division, and then on penalties beating Mansfield Town of the fourth. I'm delighted to have alongside me, as we look at referee Tom Bune, joining me in the commentary box is Lou Macari, now manager of Swindon, who actually scored in the Freight Rover Trophy this season. I think Swindon's only goal in the competition. Lou, who's your money on?
My money's on Brentford, Marvin. I watched them earlier in the competition against Reading, at Reading, and they gave them a good hiding 3-1, and I know Frank is very confident and he thinks his team next year is going to go places, so if they're going to do that next year, they've got to win here.
The pitch here at Wembley is now back to its very best. It's a new experience for all these players bar the Wigan right back Alex Cribley, who played here in a schoolboy game. Wigan in the all-blue, attack the goal to the left in the first half, looking for a double for the Lancashire Town. Their rugby league side winners here just 4 weeks ago in a memorable rugby league Challenge Cup final. Graham Barrow losing out to Gary Roberts, and a foul by Tony Kelly. Gary Roberts is very much the unpredictable force for Brentford as the free kick is taken by Jamie Murray. On from Booker, collected by Robbie Cook. And Keith Castles had run offside. Both of these teams do have reputations for trying to play football, to play their way through midfield. Tunks savours Wembley at last, at the end of his 17th season as a league professional. Both clubs have played here before. Wigan were here in the FA Trophy in 1973, where they lost to Scarborough. Brentford won a London War Cup final back in 1942. And oddly enough, played a league game here against Clapton Orient back in 1930. Well, Brentford, as you can see, in terms of support, are here in force. It it is very, very warm. And Lou, you've played here on warm days. How difficult does it get for players?
Well, it's not very pleasant, Martin, and take into consideration these players have actually been finished 2 weeks, so they've been 2 weeks hanging about training only. I would think at the end of the game there'll be some very tired legs.
Nice ball by Salmon. And a miscue by Knowles. Kamara had the shot. And Kevin Langley with a strange back pass, and it is a corner. First corner goes the way of Brentford, and you mentioned, Lou, that they've gone almost a fortnight since their last competitive match. In fact, Brentford have had a week in Corfu, partly relaxation, maybe mostly relaxation, and we'll see what effect that's had. So Wignall is up for the corner, a header from Keith Millen. The goalkeeper had to be brave in front of Booker.
Yes, twice within 2 minutes, Martin, Chris Kamara's had a good chance, and this one here, it was a half chance for him, and he just snatched it, and I think he got blocked on his shins, and let's hope Wembley hasn't does his notorious thing of players getting injured.
Here's David Lowe, an England youth international. Newell held it up well. Back from Lowe, who was flattened by Hurlock. Wigan had possession, which they've now lost, and now got back again. Knowles with the cross, and it was just touched away as Graham Barrow came in. Here's Murray. And Langley takes it up. Skewed behind by Millen. Such limited league experience, the 18-year-old who's come into the Brentford side in only the last couple of months. And one of Wigan's youngsters, Steve Walsh, who's only 20, has come forward. Newell shot. The first real strike of meaning. It's come from Wigan. Supporters may be outnumbered.
We've got a chance, Martin, here, I think, of a few goals in a game like this. Third and fourth division players have got a habit of making mistakes, and it's mistakes that bring goals. Let's hope we see plenty here today.
Well, Keith Castles and Gary Roberts, the joint leading scorers for Brentford, with 18 goals this season, but Robbie Cook chasing on has 22 to his name. Seven of those were for Cambridge United, club he started the season with. And Barry Knowles, he started in non-league football this season with Barrow, and now here he is playing for Wigan at Wembley. And there's no stinting in the challenges. Free kick against Barrow. And it's not often that Terry Hurlock limps out of a collision. Plenty of movement ahead of Castles. Coming round the back was Wignall. It was just flicked onto him, I think, which is why he couldn't control. Roy Tunks. As Wignall tried to get round the back of Wigan. Tunks is on the coaching staff with Wigan. He's just been offered a new contract. Booker went in bravely, and it reaches Cook. Roberts in the middle, so too is Kamara. Cook goes his own way. The angle was against him. But he's a player with a proven goal-scoring record. John talking to the Wigan chairman, Brian Heathcote. Here's Lowe. Newell ahead of him is offside. And although There are cheers from the other end of the ground. The linesman Eric Hart with the flag rightly raised. But all the early indications of an open contest. In fact, in the two league meetings in the third division this season, Brentford have had the better of things, taking 4 points, winning at home and drawing up at Springfield Park. Here's Gary Bennett trying to stretch the legs, matched all the way by Jamie Murray. And if you're looking for romantic stories, Gary Phillips provides one. He only signed for Brentford from Barnet in December. And Frank McClintock has seen it all in terms of Wembley. Six finals, as I was saying, but he's only been a winner once as a player. Walsh just slipping for a moment. It's Cribbley there, who has played at Wembley before for Merseyside Schools. Kamara, happily in full working order now after that early knock. Might come for Salmon. Showing the inside by Lowe. Bob Booker, who's a real versatile performer for Brentford, often used in defence or in midfield, but now given the role with which he started his league career as an out-and-out forward. Castles. Three waiting for the cross if Castles can oblige. And Cook left it. Booker came in behind him. And they were straight at Tunks. But here's Graham Barrow trying to get Wigan going.
There's a tremendous header from Bob Booker there from Keith Cassell's cross. As you said earlier, Martin, Booker's played in every position for Brentford. But I think up front's possibly his best.
The Freight Rover Trophy, entered by all the third and fourth division clubs. Tournament played over the second half of the season, when really they're out of the FA Cup and the Milk Cup. And it's brought tremendous revenue. Newell knocked it down, it almost reached David Lowe. Walsh, and it might come yet for Lowe. Desperate defending by Millen. A good touch from Roberts. And then it's in the goalkeeper's arms from Langley. It was hardly a shot, really. But Keith Millen in the thick of things in his own penalty area then. In league and cup ties. Wigan have also finished the season strongly. Brian Hamilton, only manager since the end of March, when his first task was to keep Wigan in the third division. Newell trying to take it on the chest, and in the end he went down as he fouled Kamara. Walsh wants to let it run. Steve Walsh, very much cast in the mould of a former Wigan manager who played a big part in the development of Steve Walsh, Larry Lloyd. He's a left-sided central defender. Perhaps Lou doesn't quite carry as many pounds as Larry did at the end of his career.
I would hope not, Martin. I'm still playing.
Brian Hamilton, Wigan's manager, actually played in this tournament this season, but played for Tranmere. So he's cup-tied, and I think otherwise he might well have got one of the two substitutes shirts available in this tournament. And it is quite possible that that will come into the Football League next season. Something that will be raised at the league AGM shortly. Barrow, time to settle, and Herlock lashed out, and that was really quite unnecessary. Tom Bune speaks to Herlock, who sometimes walks a narrow line between being competitive and being downright out of order. No recriminations from Barrow, but the ball had long gone. Barrow's header, low, popped away by Millen. I never thought that Salmon used an arm, the referee didn't think so. Knowles, and Lowe is offside. There's a look of enterprise, though, about Wigan, Lou.
Yes, but they're a northern team, and they won't go down without a fight. Incidentally, that foul by Terry Herlock there, that's the one thing we don't want to see, especially in front of so many children.
Castles, I think it's a goal kick. The family final, it says, and so many parents encouraged to bring their children here to Wembley. And they're watching so many young players on the pitch too. Wigan really are blessed with a crop of talented youngsters. They'll have a job to hang on to them. Mike Newell, one of the 20-year-olds. Keith Millen, only 18, marking him. Kelly. And Phillips has to go down. It might just have been sneaking inside the near post. The goalkeeper couldn't be sure. Wigan, the youngest of the Football League clubs, elected in 1978, place of Southport. Brentford have a much richer tradition. They were in the first division when football resumed after the Second World War. And they do have a deep reservoir of support. And a lot of those supporters who will follow the club from the newspapers and the television, and maybe not go to Griffin Park, but certainly come here today. Knowles with the cross, and Barrow goes in, just flicked away from him. Millen is really defending well, Lou, in this early phase.
That was tremendous defensive qualities there. It looked all over a goal. Tremendous ball from the left back, and had the centre forward got his head, there was no way the goalkeeper would have stopped it.
So Wigan have the corner. Methven is forward from the back, and so too the number five, Walsh. It was an under-hit corner by David Lowe. Wigan were rehearsing their corners here yesterday. McClintock, whose season has been really a tale of two halves. Brentford, very unconvincing up until the Christmas period. But suddenly he sorted out one or two problems. The signing of Robbie Cook was crucial for him. And defensively, Brentford have been much tighter over the second part of the season. Herlock has always provided their fight in midfield. And he overstepped the mark again. Walsh to take the free kick. Graham Barrow the target, and Newell looking to feed off him, and Lowe is there as well. Barrow again, Newell, now Lowe, the shot was from Langley. Brentford getting bodies in the way. Pribley. Castles. Here's Cook. And Langley, who has tremendous class in midfield, but Cook will be spoken to and will be booked. Again, it's too much to say that it was over-enthusiasm, really. Langley had done so well, and Cook showing his frustration. Tom Bune had the notebook out, quite rightly too.